no, but I'm on this every day. You cannot run with me, boy, I'm a heavyweight. Baby, I know what's coming, I could barely wait. And when it was on, they wanted me gone, boy, I'm here to stay. Stop calling me low, bro, I got mileage on me. Walked in with the whole team and we riding on it. More action and enough talk, I went quiet on it. Walked in with the whole team and we riding on it.
I don't be with him, he's so basic. Well, you the op in your boys.
Tonight, from U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis, it's time for Monday Night Football on EA Sports. Vikings taking on the Los Angeles Rams.
Spread between 4th and 6th streets in downtown Minneapolis, we welcome you inside spacious U.S. Bank Stadium. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Los Angeles Rams and the Minnesota Vikings. Again, everyone, Brandon Gordon alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, you look at this Vikings ball club. They come in off a loss in the season opener, which doubled as the home opener.
And when you lose that way, at home, season opener, it almost feels like two losses. So it's a big...
Fake. Brown. That's complete to Justin Jefferson. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. The end result, 21 yards. And we see the emphasis early here. Get your star receiver involved, able to do it successfully.
Not a bad start to begin with, that's for sure. And to me, this play says our guy is better than your guy's up. Because, you know, a player of his stature, he won't just be single covered all game long. It's going to involve multiple people. And right away, they told the other team, guess what? He's just better.
The first carry now for Dalvin Cook. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
2 yards on the
give to Cook out of the gun. Another 2 yard gain there, but they'll need to do better this time. It's 3rd and 6. 2 yards on the first down carry, and then followed up by 2 yards on the second down carry.
Well, that's definitely not going to be enough to get the job done. Wasn't the expression 3 yards in a cloud of dust?
Now they're going to need 6 on third down to keep the drive going. Brown now to throw on third down. This to Jarwin. And he can only manage to get this to the 45-yard line. Well short of the first.
Well, the coverage was tight that time. They allowed the pass underneath to him, but they rallied to him pretty fast, too. Converged on him and got him down. That'll bring up 4th down.
On 4th down, Joseph Charlton on to punt. Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. And this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. So out come the Rams now for their first possession. And they'll be led out by the man running the show, Charles, their quarterback.
I read something prepping for this game that he said prior to. And I think he really said it a few months ago, where he talked about he wants to have the type of season that at the end, he's buying gifts for all the guys who helped him along the way. And I know that the team wants to hold him to that and really get into his wallet. But that's what good leadership gives you. You know, at the end of the season, because you've done a great job, QB, he's usually the guy who springs for the good stuff.
In a word, I would say productive, finding the end zone three different times.
Is it possible that you're really underselling it? Three touchdowns, you're just going to call him productive?
What do you want?
This guy had a nose for the end zone.
He was good.
Had a snootful, didn't he? How about that? Big time game.
The throw on the quick slant, going to be complete. The 40, 30, 10. Touchdown, LA.
Touchdown,
Cooper Kupp. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Rams are going to take a first quarter lead. And nothing too crazy there. A quick slant, and then he just had a seam. He found a seam.
And when you hit it on the run like that, and I mean the pass right to the receiver who's already in motion and moving, sometimes he just takes it and runs away from everyone else.
And he ran it into the end zone. And the defense, they've got to adjust there quickly. That's tough on them.
That's really tough because everything was executed well. Ball was out of his hands quickly, into the hands of the receiver, and then he was gone.
Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
Take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Vikings taking the field here for their second drive of the game. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
Part of the thinking when you bring in extra tight ends, you're hoping that each of your guys gets those one-on-one blocks and creates a crease for your runner. You know what the converse is, though? You've got to win those one-on-one blocks. And when you don't, that's the result you end up with.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's 2nd and 12. Operating from the gun, Brown. He gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook. And on 3rd and 8, defensively, they're going to beef up the secondary. 6 defensive backs. From the gun, Brown. And that one's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Looks like a second empty possession to start the game, and certainly not the way you want to start when you're coming off of a loss last week. Every team talks about starting fast. They're hoping on their next possession, it can be a delayed fast start and get them going.
That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. So the Rams coming back onto the field, their second drive of the game. And they'll be looking to make this a 2-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their first drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up 2 scores here on the road. That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing, and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did some of that.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9. From the shotgun, here's a give to Akers. This will be a short gain of 3 before he's brought down at the 22. An extra defender in the secondary for the Vikings here on 3rd down.
3-yard gain on the play. Brings up 3rd down.
Back to throw here. Hard throw, incomplete.
This is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a 3-and-out and giving the ball back to their offense?
A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Vikings will take over here, 1st and 10. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And last drive, 3-and-out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a 1st down and get some momentum going. It's has been a struggle for him throughout the game, and that three and out on the last possession really told you just how starved they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down. He's obviously a bit of a shorter running back. Sometimes when he goes up the middle like that, he gets lost in there, then he pops out for 10, 20 yards.
I actually asked NFL linebackers if that was true. Do you actually lose sight of some of the smaller running backs? And all of them confirmed that that can be a problem. Think of it this way. Two of the top running backs in NFL history, Emmitt Smith, Barry Sanders, both 5'10".
Got an open man, the tight end, Jarwin. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. These are his numbers from last week's contest. Six catches, 68 yards.
And they think they have a matchup advantage in this one. They're going to try and find some space for him to work and make sure he touches the football.
Now throwing on first down and completing it. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
Well, it certainly doesn't matter if it's been through the air like on this play or on the ground. I don't know what's going on with this defense. In a sense, they've been AWOL on this drive so far. Three plays, three first downs given up. They've got to find answers, and they've got to find them quick.
So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 37-yard line. Back to throw, Brown. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. Throwing again, Brown. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 15-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22.
That was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
First red zone chance now for the Vikings. They've got a first and 10 at the 15. They'll look to throw again. Outright completes it to Jarwin. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Brown to throw on second down. That's complete right around the 8. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 and the 6. It's an 8-yard pickup, and that'll bring up a 3rd and 1. Again, he'll drop to throw. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
And what did we talk with them about prior to the game? Their ability to move the chains, pick up first downs. So far, 0 for 3 on third down. If that continues, they'll have a little chance of winning this one.
Makes the score Rams 7, Vikings 3.
So they do get 3 points, but that's now 3 drives with only the 3 points, not a ratio that's going to win you many ball games.
Not at all, Brandon. And think about it this way. We all know payoff is the key, right? And wouldn't we love to have the concession on every T-shirt that's been printed in football that says finish on it? Because that's the mantra everywhere. Got to be able to finish drives, put points on the board.
L.A. readies for its next possession. And they're coming off a 3 and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
They got him in. It's Woods. And he is going to have a Rams first down as they convert on third and three with a nice gain of 7 yards.
First down, Los Angeles.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered, but how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A gain of 13, it's a first down. They'll run this with Akers. They find some open field here. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 13-yard gain yet again, just like last play.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all, challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge.
On first down, they'll stay with Akers on the ground. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six.
It's now second and six.
He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And down to the 16-yard line.
Isaiah Simmons.
This has been a good drive so far, and it's been the running game for the most part that's powered them down there. Another nice burst there, picking up a first down. Now it's first and 10, as you said, in the red zone.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. A quick pass to Kupp. And the Rams are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. 12 more yards there and another first down. Defensively, they're going to have to do something about him in a hurry because that last catch puts him over the 100-yard mark. We haven't even hit the second quarter yet.
And you did say they'd have to do it in a hurry. It has to be right now because as his confidence grows, it'll actually overwhelm the defense. No matter what they do, he'll feel like they can't
score. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. From 4 yards out, and the Rams add on to their lead.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury, and it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run, and he finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
Extra point attempt to come here. This one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it winds up with a touchdown for Los Angeles. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will make it into the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
Their own 25
yards. Now out comes Minnesota. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation.
Popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
First and 10.
That was a really nice interception. I think it illustrates the differences between playing man and playing zone. When you're in man, all you're focused on is the receiver in front of you. But when you're in zone, you're allowed to read the quarterback's eyes and go to the ball. That's exactly what happened on that play.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. On the counter, this is Akers. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
As a linebacker, you're taught to stay just slightly behind the ball carrier just in case he makes a cutback. But when you find the gap, shoot it. And he found it all right. Took it straight into the backfield and made the tackle for a loss.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. That's complete to his tight end, Higbee. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
To Tyler Higbee. A gain of 6 yards. And it's third down.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Smith catches left side. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. And his kick is good. And they will stretch the lead now to 17-3.
Vikings 3.
They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for 3. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
Minnesota now ready for their next possession. And last time, one play interception, so this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it, and I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it, and let him fling another one. Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense, diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
Now Brown looking to throw on second down. Incomplete. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9 yards
to go.
Operating from the gun, Brown got an open man finding Jefferson. And he will have the Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A big connection on that one. 31 yards.
43-yard line.
Entertaining start to this one. More to come on EA Sports.
17, Vikings 3.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Off play action, Brown. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon, and guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback.
Been such an impressive first half to get that lead. Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. From the gun, Brown. This one caught by Davis. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. The Vikings on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is third and 14. That'll be complete to Cook. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20.
That was a beautifully executed screen pass. He let the rushers get upfield and get the escorts in front, meaning the offensive linemen, other blockers out in front, completed the pass beautifully. So now you've got all that open space with big guys leading the way.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. To Jefferson on the slant. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Brings up second and 2.
Here's Brown to throw on second down. This will be caught at about the 5. His 5th catch tonight, and it's good for a first down.
First and goal at the 3-yard line.
They'll run for it with Cook. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Vikings are able to make this a close game again. People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that. It wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
On here, Brandon McManus for the point after. And it's up through the goalpost. It's 17-10. That time, a 9-play drive. And it's capped off by the touchdown run coming from Dalvin Cook. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And this will make it into the end zone. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. Get a look at this offense led by Cooper Kupp as they make their way back onto the field. Making his presence felt early in this one. First half, already over the century mark.
How about the yards per completion, too? That's a pretty darn good number there. Number of catches, but he's shredding defense. He's getting big yardage with each and every one of them.
Now a throw over the middle, and he's got it to start the drive. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Gain of 9 brings up second and 1 at the 34-yard line.
Here's a run with Akers on second down. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
A gain of 5. First down, Los Angeles.
Now a run with Akers. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Sometimes you get all those big guys down there at one spot, and there's just nowhere to go. And in this case, the defensive tackle used his strength and swallowed him up.
Second and 11. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Throw left side complete. That's Smith. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
And the Rams.
They'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. He was brought down by Eric Wilson.
And what we just saw there, partner, was linebacking speed that can trump O-line power. We see that at times because he filled the gap before the offensive lineman could get to the next level and take him on.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. They'll set up a throw. They got a man over the middle. It's Woods.
The pass.
And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
Third down.
Open man, Higbee, the tight end. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. It's a gain of 11 and a first down, L.A.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
Six.
They'll look to throw now on first down.
Gets this into the hands of the tight end, Higbee.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup,
and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his fifth catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight ends. On second down now, Akers. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, so it was looking good, but nothing there. Now it's third down and inches.
And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to convert on third and short yardage with a gain of four.
And they pick up the first down there with a gain of four.
Just about every coach we talk to says the crowd shouldn't affect us. That shouldn't be an issue. And then the next breath they talk about taking the crowd and taking them out of the game by picking up first downs and keeping them at bay. I think we just saw an example of that there, didn't we?
Important to do, especially early in the game like they have. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. They'll run here with Akers. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. It was Alton Robinson that time on the tackle.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Here's Akers. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and four now.
And it's third down.
Now back to throw. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
Always important as a defender on third down to keep the play in front of you and make sure you don't give up enough space that they can make a move on you in the open field. Try as he might, he wasn't able to get to the first down marker. Excellent defense, good tackling.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. This from 25 yards out. And his kick is indeed good. And they double him up here. That makes our score 20-10.
Vikings 10.
So good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coach is always talking about finishing a drive with a kick. Two of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
You see Dalvin Cook in the offense heading back out. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call in the West Coast offense, the long handoff? Yeah.
And down he goes on the pressure from the Rams defense. Aaron Donald in there to get him. It's a loss of five.
That's a pretty darn good start to his season, huh? A sack in the opener, adds a second one here. That tells you about his offseason. He came in determined to have a big year, and it's paying off.
Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack. Operating from the gun. Brown. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Well, it was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving them exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
The Vikings on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be third and forever. Looking to throw. Brown. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 38. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
So it's third and long, and you know this is going to be a pass. So defensively, they're bringing an extra defensive back and just blanket the field. And this is an ill-advised throw right here as it winds up being picked off easily.
set to go again. Here's Cam Akers in the LA offense.
He's been effective so far over the 40-yard mark here in the second quarter. Don't forget about those guys up front, though. They've been effective, too.
The leverage game has been in their favor. They've been the ones who've been able to bend their knees, drop their hips, and get a little bit lower than the guys on the other side of the football. They've moved them out of the way for the runner.
Sometimes that's tough for those big fellas.
Not an easy thing for them to do.
16 yards is the pickup there and a first down for LA.
And he went in route there from the slot for the completion.
Love how he runs his routes because it's all setting up your defender. Give him a little something one way, take it the other way. Head and shoulder fake. Sometimes you make one step to the outside, then break it inside. Really well run route.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Open man is Higbee, the tight end.
The pass.
A gain of six there on first.
Tyler Higbee. It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four at the 18-yard line.
Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four.
They'll run a draw now with Akers.
And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, third and five.
No daylight for him to run through there, and he ran into the defensive tackle, and that guy blocks a whole lot of daylight as it is. He is truly a big man who just made a big play.
The Rams on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be third and five.
He'll throw complete to Cam Akers.
And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11.
A gain of 7.
Give him 7 yards on the play as they do pick up the third down conversion.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. On the handoff, it's Akers.
And a nice pickup there as he'll take it from the 10 down to the 5-yard line.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5.
A gain of 5 brings up second and 5.
And he's got it. That's Kupp for a Ram touchdown.
Los Angeles.
Cooper Kupp with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Rams add on to their lead.
Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, 2 touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Now the extra point try forthcoming. And that'll make this a 3-score game as the lead moves to 17. So the drive there took 6 plays. And the result for the Rams, a touchdown. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25.
Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. And I guess the question, Charles, is what's the formula for keeping him better protected? Because as we see, the protection, it struggled.
And normally what you get is renewed determination. When the big guy gets hit, that usually sparks people. Hey, we can't let this happen anymore. They take it personally. He's not supposed to be on the ground, but that hasn't been the case so far in this game. So maybe they've got to figure out how do they get rid of the ball faster to help out the offensive line so he doesn't get hit as much.
And we'll see if they can keep him off the ground now going forward.
A gain of 2 brings up second and 8 at the 27-yard line.
Brown now looking to throw on second down. And the Rams got it. They bring him down.
Second quarter action, 1:56 remaining.
A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. And here's Joseph Charlton now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. It's taken to the 26. So a good punt, but a solid 12-yard return. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. Out comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. And how about the start so far, Charles? 3 first half touchdown passes.
And that's how you generate excitement on a team. Keep your offense moving at a really high level. And it's also how you establish leadership by playing that well. 3 touchdown passes, that's the way to lead.
Now he's just hoping for number 4. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
And he can't escape, and down he goes.
A loss of 14 on the play. It's second down.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. This one to the left to Higbee. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. Out of the gun now on third down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he gets this only to the 44-yard line. Not near enough to keep the drive alive. Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds. And they'll spot it right at the 20.
At their own.
Now the Vikings offense gets set to take over here. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Operating from the 27 now, here's second and 3. Got an open man, the tight end, Jarwin. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Brown throwing on first down. Fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
They will find Davis. That's complete. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. And he finds Cook. The Vikings going to use their 3rd and final timeout as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Now Brown on first down. This to Jarwin.
Brown's pass complete to Blake Jarwin.
So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. We'll get back to you and Charles in a minute. But first, time to give the folks at home a look at what's going on around the NFL. We'll start over at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, where it was definitely a game with some intrigue, as you can see by the scoreline. Dak Prescott, 5 touchdown passes, leading his guys to the victory. From there, we're off to check out another game. And they were winners as they defeat the visiting New England Patriots. Anthony Miller leading the way with 3 touchdown catches. Lastly, let's get to Pittsburgh. Check on the Steelers at home at Heinz Field. And they were winners in that one over the visiting Raiders. 24-16 was how that one finished. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The Rams going to get the football first here, and they look to build on their lead as the second half gets started. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
At their own 26-yard line.
So here are the Rams to take over. They were winners a week ago against Buffalo, and they lead here with a 1st and 10. Try and start this drive in the air. Going to Woods, but that pass is intercepted. Picked off the end of 42. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
I think this is where you have to have the term situational football in your head, because this game is pretty much in the palm of your hand, and the one thing you can't afford to do, turn the ball over. Now you've given the patient a little bit of a heartbeat, haven't you? And now they're feeling it, and they're back in this game.
Yeah, still a little bit of a lead, but that makes things more interesting. We're still just in the third quarter here. McManus now for the extra point. And the lead is trimmed down to 10. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Taken at about the 1. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
At their own 26-yard line.
L.A. set to take over again on offense. They've got to right the ship. They had a great first half, but the lead has really gone down. Now, you know, you always talk about the adjustment to the adjustment. They've got to adjust right here.
And I think a lot of it is just mental. Get back to doing what...
Looking to start for Woods, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Anthony Harris. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. So a pick six there out of the nickel package. They went with 5 DBs.
Almost becoming the base package in the NFL is the nickel. Hard to throw against. That was demonstrated one more time. A pick six going the other way.
McManus to tack on the extra point. And the lead is down to a field goal now. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Taken at about the 1. And they get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
The Rams take over 1st and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
Here's a Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. First down, they'll start out with Akers. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Now a look at Smith. Not sure exactly what happened, but he's still down. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break.
working with a second and four. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete. And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points. You rarely call your punter a weapon, but he certainly was there. How about that? Pinning him down at the one-yard line and helping out the defense in a big way. I'm telling you what, if I'm a defensive coordinator, I might be thinking safety right now.
Trying to fire up that running game with Dalvin Cook. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and six at the 5-yard line.
Again, it's Cook. And a short gain here as he gets it up only to about the six.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Back to throw. Brown. And he's going down for the fifth time today. And this one is going to be a safety. So the screen pass goes backwards. That play seemed to have a potential disaster written all over it from the start.
I mean, wasn't that a tough spot on the field to make that call? You're inviting defensive linemen and linebackers to get pressure. So if one of them sniffs this out, you're definitely in danger. And this time, it costs them 2 points.
So a free kick situation forthcoming from the 20 as they'll punt this one away. This is taken at the 18. Set to go again. Here's Cam Akers in the LA offense. And as the numbers show, he really wasn't in the mix at the beginning, but they've got him in the rotation now, and it's proved a good move.
And that's what happens when you're a good player. There's a lot more attention drawn to you, and it's obvious that they had him in their game plan on defense, not letting him get off to a good start, but he's found a way so far here in the second half.
They'll begin on the ground with Akers. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And it'll bring up a second and 13. Going right back to Akers. And yet again, he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Great job by this Vikings defense. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down.
I'll tell you what, this defense hasn't played its best, but they're still right in this football game. And if they keep making plays just like that, they're going to give their offense a chance.
So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. He'll get this to Akers out of the backfield. And this play comes to a halt at the 33, and obviously that's well short of the first down. Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he's on to punt for the fourth time tonight. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And this one hits at the 3 and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback.
20-yard line.
Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. And they don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Sure.
just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead, take it, set it aside, and move forward.
And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
Well, the pressure, the hits, the sacks have been coming at him all game long. I'm frankly surprised that they haven't found a solution yet to create more time for him to throw it, or maybe change what they do on offense.
And that's one of the biggest differences in this game and why they're losing right now. Dalvin Cook is running back, the intended target. Third down here.
Brings up third down and 10.
Looking to throw. Brown setting up the screen for Cook. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first.
I like the play design there. They occupied the defense downfield. Everyone trying to account for someone. But unfortunately, they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield. And he was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
A big loss on the play.
Oh, free safety blitz. That can be a gamble, but it proves fruitful there.
Yeah, you're exactly right about the gamble because oftentimes the free safety is the last line of defense against a long pass. And when he comes at the quarterback, he'd better get home and make the play. Otherwise, a big play could result for the offense.
After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. From the gun, Brown going underneath, complete to Jarwin. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Brings up third down.
Operating from the gun, Brown. He'll get this one complete to Davis. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. The Vikings send out their punter. He's been terrific so far. Good open field tackling there. A 50-yard punt followed by just a 1-yard return. And that will come the offense as they take over. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
A gain of 4. It's now 2nd and 6 at the 26-yard line.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on third down?
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down. That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
Running the ball can be a struggle in this part of the field. In fact, it's a perfect spot for defenders to pin their ears back and try and work up field, and they capture him for a loss.
And after the loss to start out. Here's second and 11. They run it again with Cook. And he's upended at the six as they double their room to maneuver on a pickup of three.
At his own 6-yard line. It's a gain of three. Brings up third and 8.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. From the gun, Brown. He's going to get this one down to Cook, and he will get him down a couple yards shy of the first down marker. A nice tackle coming.